Hello everyone! Wendy and I have worked a lot today, so I will show you our work.
So we have gas, we have I don't know what it is, iron from cars maybe, tires. Aha! We had the oil with Wendy. Yes. I show the brand because we need to know who pollutes the planet. And here we have the waste from construction. And here we have the tires again. Here we have all the toxic products. Here we have the waste from construction and the mattress. Here we have, I don't know what it is. Many tires. And Wendy. And I will show you the wonderful sky tonight. Because that's the reason why I do what I do. Because I hate having all this dirt and rubbish and waste on the beach. When I admire my sunset, so I work a lot, but I'm proud of what I do. And I'm very well supported by Wendy, and together we had Annie.
So if ever some people don't know what to do of their life, we have a big thing to do in Ventimiglia with the waste and many tires and many things from the sector actually of automotive and construction, and actually this is the true face of those two sectors behind. Okay, so I'll leave you and I'll go back in a while, and I hope I will do some more for this waste and clean the beach. You might know as well that in Ventimiglia we have some people who live on the beach, and this is why I do this cleaning as well, because I don't think this is a proper environment, you know, for them to stay. I think that everyone should give a hand, you know, by helping this cleaning and, you know, providing a better place for everyone. Yes, so now I will show you our wonderful sunset, and I hope you will come and join us in Ventimiglia to help the cleaning. Thanks a lot. Here it is, tonight we have a wonderful pink and purple sky. So that's my gift of the day after this hard work. And tomorrow will be another day. Hello people, I hope you're doing well. I'm still in Ventimiglia on the beach, cleaning the wood and the different products derived from the oil industry, and it's a hard work, and many tires and many pieces of metal as well, so it's very dangerous, you know, for the children. And we had this information, you know, from the city, and they said it was really dangerous to go on the beach, you know, for the families and everything. So I decided to spend a couple of hours this afternoon as well to make a path actually from the shore to the beach, a safe path. So you know, we have this little wood path, you know, which is on the bridge. It was full of wood and everything, so I cleaned everything, and then I moved the wood which is on the shore, most of the wood, because it's really heavy, and we have some big trunks as well, and I opened the path. So I mean, the families will be able to go to the shore safely and enjoy the beach, because behind the wood line it's safe because the sea has gone away. So the path is not very big because we have a big trunk, and it's too heavy for me, you know, I can't take it off. But at least there is a small path for the families so they can go. So I will show you my work, and you see how we are now. So here on the left we have my cleaning station for all the tires and everything, and here is the wood path, and here we have Wendy, and we need to know that this wood path was full of wood, as you can see. I put it everything on the right side, so now it's opened, so we can walk safely until the end. And the thing is that at the end of the wood path we had, as you can see, very big woods. And especially this one, and I can't move it, so I had to leave it. But I found this thing,
So I made a corner so we can go. And then, see here, we have the big wood. Well, I left a bit of waste that I'm going to take away in a minute. But we have, just move this, a path, which is safe, mostly, for the families. So here we have a trunk and my waste that I'm going to put in my cleaning station. And here we have the small path that I opened. So see people, I don't think if you realize, but there was maybe like 5 meters of wood, and I cleaned everything. So all this wood, which is there, it's me who took it away. So it's quite tiring, actually. And then here, the problem is that I found all this wood and I can't take it off. It's too heavy and it's in the sand. But if we do like this over, it's fine. And then we are safe on the beach. So I'm not finished yet. See, I have to clean this one and all these little things. But then after, we're totally safe. As you can see, behind the wood waste, we're fine. So the path is here, just in front of the video game Las Vegas 2000. So for the people who want to bring the kids, here is the way to the safe pass. So I'm going to finish the cleaning so everything is fine for the people when they want to go. So I believe it's not much actually, but it's very important, you know, for us to have a safe way to reach the beach, because we need to know that in this wood we have some dead animals and it's just decay and it's very disgusting, and it's a big problem actually for the families, you know, for the children, because they could get hurt with the metal, they could find some toxic products, some dead animals and everything. So it's a big health problem as well, and so this is why I opened the path. So make all this area of the beach clean. It's gonna take a long time, but I'm gonna try, and then I'll go on the other parts. And the important today is that we have a path, a free path to the beach, and yes, that's the D-Day to retake possession of the territory. And I'm very proud of myself. And oh yes, I have a very good news as well. I met a guy on the beach and he said that he would come and help me on Monday, so I'm very happy about that, because I guess he has big muscles and he will be able to help me carry the big trunks and everything. So that's important. And I hope the people in Ventimiglia, when they're finished with the mud, they come to the beach, because we need their help. Okay, people, so tonight we'll do a little bit of awareness with what we found on the beach with Wendy. So I will show you. So once again, we had many tires and metal things, which are very dangerous, actually. And I found a lot of, I don't know what it is, very dangerous, all these things. It's very heavy, and this as well, very dangerous. And actually, Wendy has a message for us today. So we have a sign actually saying that it's very dangerous in the Roya Valley, because we have sudden floods in the Roya. So actually I found this sign on the beach, so I don't know how the people are gonna do now in the mountains to know that we can have sudden floods in the Roya. So Wendy, I don't know what you think, but I think we should do a little bit of awareness so everybody knows. What do you think? Yes? Yes? Wendy? And still many toxic products and everything. And I found some, you know, toys for the children, balloons and rain boots and everything. So, lots of polystyrene as well. And many, many tires. And actually, I know where those tires come from. And I know the company which has lost its tire on the Roya River. And actually, this is a very big problem, because this man was keeping all the tires in the garden, knowing that he was in a zone of flood, and that's how they all arrived. So Mr. Tire, all your tires are on my beach, in my cleaning zone, so if you want to come and talk to me and get your tires, you're welcome. As you might know, people, actually, the beach cleaning in Ventimiglia and the path open to this is sponsored by the Princess of the Environment, Princess Rose, and the Expedition of the Planet. Because we need to know that nobody has come to help us, nor the army, nor anyone in Italy, so we're a bit left on our own. But we're brave and we have big muscles, and we will do the cleaning, because we don't want to stay in this mess. So now people have a very big surprise, and look at this, this is why I come. So I'm gonna go to the beach with a safe path, and I will show you the lovely Ventimiglia sunset.
The sunset tonight with lovely colors, and see there on the mountains of the Roya, it's very cloudy, and actually we're expecting new rains for tomorrow during the whole day, so I don't know if I'll be able to come and clean, but I will try and see how peaceful it is. Just so lovely, and we have nice colors, and yes, this sunset is very well deserved tonight. It was a hard day of work, but it's worth. And I would like to empower you people, like if you have a bit of time, you know, to give for our planet here in Ventimiglia, we need your help. Because as I told you, we are left on our own. We have no help from the state, and actually the Italian army is not here to help either. Whereas in France, the army is helping in the mountains, and the professional people are on the beach, even with the prisoners, you know, from the jails. Everyone helps in France, but not here. I mean, the population is still dealing with the mud in their houses and everywhere in the city, and nobody is taking care of the beach. So, yes, if you want to come here on holidays next year, come and help us now, because we need it. Okay, I'm sharing with you people the last light of the sun before it goes behind the mountain, and see how beautiful it is. It's very peaceful tonight, and we can imagine actually a week ago we were struck by this heavy flood, and I guess everybody will ever remember that. And yes, this is the light of hope, you know, of our future, and someday everything will be over. And yes, we need to believe in that, and tomorrow will be another day. Hello people, I hope you're doing well. So I'm back to my cleaning station on the beach after Storm Alex and all the damage that caused the city of Ventimiglia. And today my plan is to finish the security of my wood path and cut the branches, and also to take the big waste out of the beach. And actually when I arrived, I saw that some people have stolen some of the waste, and the people now come and make their dog poo in the waste. So we're just living in hell. I mean, no help from the state, and no help from anyone, and people who steal the waste, and the people who come with their dog and do their poo there. It's just so horrible. So anyway, I keep the faith, and I go on with my work, and because, you know, I think I have to be over all these problems and make the things go better here. Okay, so I'll show you my work today.
First, I'm very proud because see this woman, she's now using my wood path, and this shows that what I do is useful for the people, and they enjoy actually having this freedom again of this wood path. And that's very important for me to show, because many people think that I shouldn't do what I do, and what I do is not useful, but see this woman, she's happy, and that's important.
So as you can see on this video, yesterday I didn't know how to secure actually the wood for the path there. So what I did is that I used this thing, you know, for yesterday and today. And actually now I have a tool, so I will show you what I will do. So yes, this morning I went to the shop, and actually I bought this. It's to cut the small branches of the trees, because obviously nobody has sent any tools or anything, so I have to use this little thing. But I guess, and I hope actually, it will be strong enough to cut my branches. So I go, and I will show you the result after. Okay, so I'm finished with the fact of cutting the branches for the path. But we need to know that the tool I had was a bit small, so it was hard. So I will show you. So here we have the new situations. All these little branches have been cut. So I will show you now. We have a real trench in the wood. And
there it can join the wood path. So we're now fine and we have a good trench, you know, to reach the sea. Well, today it's a little bit cloudy and we had rain, but the water has increased a little bit, you know, on the shore. But I guess in the upcoming days, you know, the people there will be happy. So that's important. And as I showed you previously, here we have now two men on the wood path. So it shows that what I do works and the people are happy and safe. And this is very important. And this is what I do. So now I have this mess in front of me. And I have to take the tires and everything that we'll find in here. And then I'll head a little bit maybe on the Roya to see the big waste. We have very big things again, so I'll keep working. Okay, I'll go. Here is people where I talk about problems, you know, for health, because with the tsunami of wood, we have many fish and many animals actually who died in the wood tsunami. And actually we have many cats as well. And it's a very big health issues because first it stinks, and second we have all this decay on the beach, and there is a very big problem of health as well. And see people here, we have a good example to show that actually the trench could not be opened in wherever we wanted, because here we have this wood of wall, and as you can see it's just unbreakable because all the trees, and it's the sea actually who brought the trees, and there is a wall with the sand. It's just impossible. So this is why actually we didn't have many places, you know, to open this trench. And see the devastation, and we have just a huge trunks and very heavy, and that's a very big problem. And today I found a lot of metal as well in the wood, and very dangerous, you know. It's dangerous actually on the land, you know, for the people, but actually if the sea grows again, you know, with another storm, it will be dangerous as well, you know, for the boat, because the waves, they will take all the metal back in the sea. So this is why the job has to be made. See people, this is why I do what I do. See this old man, quite old actually, but thanks to the opening of the wood bridge, he can do his walk, and I guess he's happy. And that's important, you know, that's help, you know, for the elderly people as well. Because we need to know that more than the coronavirus, with this environmental crisis, you know, it's really hard for them, and very few opportunities are left for these people. And I believe that their walk on the beach is important. And because it keeps them healthy and happy, and yes, that's helping the most vulnerable people. And I want to show it to you because that's very important, and I believe that everyone should help like this, you know. It's easy to do it, give your time, and for the planet and for the people. As I see that the people use the wood path, I decided to help them to reach actually the trench between the wood. So I built a path actually, so I will show you. So indeed, to secure the people, we need to show them the way. So I built this path with those big trunks. It was quite heavy to carry, especially this one. Actually, I succeeded in moving it. And I built this thing, see? And I took all the stones, and see, I put them aside. So now we have a true path with the lines in wood, which leads actually to the little hole I created, and then to the beach. So I believe it's very easy. I just saw a family who used it, and naturally, you know, they took the path because we see the line actually with the wood. So I believe it's very important, and it will avoid as well that the people, you know, go anywhere in the beach, like those people there in the mess, which is so dangerous. So yes, I'm very proud of myself because it was quite heavy, but the result is here, so I'm happy. Okay, so we'll go on with my waste now. See here people, we have a good vision of the size of the tsunami of waste. actually. Yes, it's very huge, and see all this mess. This is why we have to clean, because as you can see here, we have metal everywhere, and we have some electric devices, and this is such a mess. It's unbelievable. And actually, what is very weird is that the people, you know, they come and look at me, but they don't help. As it was normal, you know, to see somebody, and they pass their way. It's unbelievable. So now, people, I will show you actually the result of my day with the waste. And it's been a day dedicated to metal, and I will explain you the why. So I will show you our great success with Wendy. So today with Wendy, we found on the beach Ricori. Yes, coffee. And actually, we would like to go back to our cafe and have a good cappuccino, but with all this mess, it's not possible. So I will show you the day. So all this stuff, which is metal and things, and there is a lot actually in the wood. Look at all this mess. And you know, these things, I thought a little bit, and actually I know where they come from. The people actually on the Roya River, they build houses, you know, with this metal things, you know, and it's not authorized, but they do it on the shore of the Roya, and whenever it rains, it breaks, and then it goes in the Roya. And we need to see, people, I would like to show you how dangerous it is, you know. Everybody could cut, and we find all sizes. It's very, very dangerous. And see all these things. I put this thing in my leg. You know, the people, they don't behave and they don't realize what they do in their life. This is such a shame. And yes, look at this, all this mess as well. And I had two tires today, so it's not a lot, but and actually, that was the day to open my shoe shop in Ventimiglia, yes. Because now I have a purple rain boot, a grey rain boot, a mountain shoes, and I think I have the other one. I have the other one there. So I put the two all together. So if ever the owner of the shoe wants to find his shoe, he will know. Oh, it's not the same shoes, actually. And I had these terrible shoes as well. And I found this baseball glove. It must belong to a little boy, and it must be very sad. And I will bring it home with me, and if ever he wants to have his baseball glove, he can contact me and I will give it back to him. So I put it with my thing on my back, so I take it home. And yes, I will show you now our wonderful scenery and our sunset. And I will take, of course, the wood path to go and admire this beauty. And I would like to show you actually, people, before I go, do you see those two people who walk? It's the wood line, and actually maybe like 50 meters behind, we have the tsunami of wood. So do you imagine that all this stuff that I carried, I need to walk the whole beach, you know, to bring them back here. So it's really hard, and it's a lot of walking as well, and it's a very, very big job. And yes, we would need some help actually, but so we need to know that the Italian state and the army have not responded, and I doubt actually they will. And that's a very big problem, because they leave Ventimiglia and the people of the Roya without any help, and see all this mess. So this is why I do what I do actually, to show them the true face of Nonna's instance to a small city on the shore of Italy, because we need to call the things by their name. So I'm now on my way to admire this wonderful sunset on my super wood path, and soon I will reach my how could I say my path to the little trench that I created. And yes, I see this man actually uses my path, and I'm happy, so that's fine. So here it is. It's making some photos. I see many people here, you know, as I told you, go to the beach at night to take photos, so that's very important, you know, to open the path. And here it is now, totally safe, and very proud of myself. It was hard work, all this. So I'll go and sit somewhere and and I want to show you the wonderful scenery. So as you can see, people, all this cleaning is a very hard work. And I would like actually to raise your awareness about helping the others and the meaning of all this. Because sometimes I believe that we don't realize the size of the damage, and we say, okay, somebody else will do it. But as I told you previously, it's not my job to do it. I do it because I believe it's important, and I want to avoid, as I'm an environmentalist, any kind of other pollutions, you know, on the beach. But I believe that we have to be more aware about what happens, you know, for our planet, because actually all this mess is the result of some people who don't behave and who don't take care, and they just do what they want. And I believe it's not possible to go this way anymore. So this is why I'm acting, you know, to solve all these questions and to pass the message. And actually, I would like to empower the public organizations, because with the due respect that I owe you, I'm wondering where you are and what you do. And because, of course, yes, today is Sunday, and you might be having a good Sunday at home. But, you know, for the coronavirus and all the environment, we have no, how could I say, a free day. So we have to be working and be on site and do the things that it's normal, you know. As well, I would like to say that, you know, I'm a French of Italy, and I'm quite shocked as well by the reaction of the Italian state, which doesn't help. Today we have a storm in the United States of America on the East Coast, and the National Guards are there. We had the storm Alex and the damage, you know, in France, and the army and the professional people are there. Where are the professional people and the army in Italy? We're going to laugh all about Italy, because where are they? That's just unbelievable. So I would like to share this message tonight, actually, because some of you have said to me, oh, you're doing a great job, you great citizen, and you believe in future. Yes, you're all right. But, you know, I don't need your recognition. I know what I do. I mean, that's my job, you know, to work in the field of environment. What I do is to try to make the public organizations actually aware of their responsibility. And actually, some money has been given, and by the Principality of Monaco to Ventimiglia. And actually, at this date, of the fact that we know it's Monaco who helps Ventimiglia, and Italy, we don't know where they are. I think they're on holiday somewhere. So, yes, I believe we need actually the public opinion on this file, and to go actually and talk to Rome, because I believe these people are wearing their nice suit, but they don't realize the true situation of the fact here. And I'm not saying that, you know, because I'm trying to do some interest or driving the opinion. I mean, that's my job. That's my job. So I say the things and I'm right, you know, and this is those people in Rome who are not right. So I'm talking to the deputies and all these people in Rome with a nice suit and dresses and everything. And, you know, I would like them to see what I do and what the mess in their country and in their cities, because that's not normal, you know, to leave the people this way. And the Italians, you know, the people, they're very ashamed by the government, you know, in Italy about this. And I can understand why they are so ashamed. Because first, they're left on their own, and second, everybody laughs at Italy at the world, in the world, because of this. And that's not normal. So I'm talking to you, the Italian responsibles for this country. You need to do something, and straight away, because you're just out of your responsibilities, and that's a fact. See, people, we're now at sunset, and we have a wonderful sky tonight. Some are yellow, some pink, and some purple, and some gold, and I will show you very soon, and it's just so gorgeous, and I'm sure you will find it beautiful. Here it is. Well, many clouds, but it's so lovely. And yes, this sunset will end this hard day of work, and what can I say about that? Tomorrow will be another day. We're Sunday night, people, so 1 week and 1 day after the storm Alex. And I would like to show you actually the state of the city, and it's far from being finished, and we still have a lot of mud. So I will show you. So I am beside the park, and you see we have a lot of mud, and we have this full of mud. And we have this in many streets actually of Ventimiglia, because the people are still doing the cleaning of the basements. And as you can see, even if the roads are reopened, we have mud everywhere. And see, we have another thing, you know, for the storage. And in this thing, it's not for the mud, I think it's for the waste. And you don't imagine, people, the amount of waste that we have. And I took some pictures, and I will do a little video in the upcoming days, but see this mess. And it's so smelly as well, because everything is decayed, and it's so disgusting. And see, for those who know Ventimiglia, we're just beside the park, so here we're now for the moment. And here I am at the police station, and I saw that they took a little bit of mud, but see the state. There's still some mud everywhere, you know. They're the last place to do the cleaning, because they thought about the people first. So yes, and here we have Carrefour, and yes, they started their cleaning yesterday, and it was so smelly, and I doubt they're finished. And I think they've lost a lot of food and everything. And see, we have all these big containers in each street of Ventimiglia, you know, for the waste. This is from Carrefour and Spar, and everywhere in the street. So I believe, people, you realize that the crisis due to the big flooding in Ventimiglia is far from being finished. I mean, in the city, with all the mud and the waste and everything, and also on the beach. So I said again, we need the support of the Italian state, because I doubt the people realize the situation here. And it will take ages if we do everything by ourselves. So I hope they will hear our call, because that's their duty, actually. People, I'm now having a little rest, actually, in a nice cafe in Ventimiglia. And I will say goodbye this way. And before, I will show you again the sunset. So here we are. We're in Italy, and I'll show you the amazing Italian cappuccino. And this is why, actually, I love Italy, for cappuccino and for the pizza and everything. And yes, that's the true face of Italy. And I wish I could see it more, and not the waste. Okay, so I'll leave you, people, and tomorrow will be another day. And I'll leave you in music with the wonderful Ventimiglia sunset. Bye. Hello, people, I hope you're doing well. So today is another day on the beach with the waste, and I am with Wendy, and I will show you what we found. So today, our day actually is sponsored by Motul Fluid Force, and we don't know what it is, but we know that it's a polluting product. And see, people, I worked very well today, because I was not working on the wood path as it's opened. And see what I had, many tires, and all this metal as well. And this thing is full today, and yes, a little bit there as well. So I'm very proud because it was a hard work, and actually I had some help from Luca and another guy who helped me as well a little bit, so I was happy about it. By the way, people, I would like to recall that we're still fighting against COVID-19 in Italy, and we nearly have 6,000 cases now per day. So as long as we're in the city or in the shop or even outdoor, we need to wear a face mask. Well, I do my work, you know, with the waist. I'm alone on the beach, so I don't wear it because I sweat and I can't breathe. But once I am on the shore or in the city, I always have my mask. And I think it's a way to protect ourselves, and we need to recall that we have birth crisis, this health crisis, and this environmental crisis. So now, people, I take the wood path and I go on the beach because I have a story to tell you, and I think it will be such a shame actually for Italy, but we need to know what's going on and to federate the people, and so more people come and bring their help. So I'm happy because my wood path is still here, and everything is fine and secure. And actually I talked with the people who live on the beach, and they're happy, you know, to have this path to go to the beach, and it's much better for them as well. So as you can imagine, people, I'm very upset about all this mess on the beach, which is actually the result of the human activities, you know, and some people don't care about anything. And I have to tell you another thing, which is just a shame. Because this morning I was in touch actually with the Italian army, and we talked a little bit, and I asked them why they didn't come to help us, you know, for the tsunami of wood and for the tsunami of mud. And I was so surprised by the response of the Italian military, and they said that the prefet, so the prefet is the one who is in charge of the police and the rescue and the army and everything, so the big guy and the big chief. And this man actually hasn't asked the Italian army to come and help us. So actually I'm wondering what this man needs for a catastrophe, you know, to give us support. And I find this all very pitiful. So I'm going to try to contact actually this big chief of the police and the army and everything, because I'm wondering what he does, and maybe he's gone on holidays or something, and maybe he's not informed that we have a crisis here in Ventimiglia. So I'm going to try to raise his awareness. And
so more than this environmental crisis, we need to know that here in Ventimiglia on the beach, we have some migrants who live there, and you know, there is no public service given to them, and they just put their waste on the beach and everything. And actually they're nice people, because some of them help me, you know, each day, and they do a little bit. So I guess we would have solutions to clean this beach fast. We could, the state of Italy or I don't know who, to give a little bit of money to the migrants, you know, and I could manage them, you know, to have them deal with our wasting. And more than this, than this social crisis, we have this environment and health crisis, because everything is decayed on the beach. And today it's just such a mess, and it smells a lot. And I mean, this is why I think the support of the army would be needed, and big trucks and everything. And I will show you the why, because look what I found, people. That's a bone, and I found it on the beach. So understand that if I find a bone, it means that we have dead animals as well. And it's not normal to leave all these things on the beach and don't bring assistance. So I will try actually to call this prefect in Italy and explain him the situation, the concrete things, you know. And I hope he will be smart and help us, because actually we already know now that he's the one who is in charge, and he's the one who didn't ask the army. So it's a big responsibility for that man. So I hope that he will understand what is his duty for his country, and that he will do something for that. So today, people, I have to leave the beach earlier, so there won't be any sunset, but I wanted to show you this fantastic sun, you know, on the Mediterranean Sea and our mountain. And it's the light of hope, you know, and each day we work and each day we do more, and each day is a success, actually, and that's important to mention. So people, I will leave you now, and always remember that tomorrow is another day. Bye. Hello everyone, I hope you're doing well. Tonight I'm on the beach, but I didn't do the waist today because my back is too sore. But I will go back in a couple of days. And I wanted to be here, you know, to share with you our lovely sunset on the Mediterranean. And tonight the colors are just so beautiful, so I will show it to you. I see the wood path is still there, so that's a good sign. It remains open, and it's quite pleasant, you know, for the people. And actually, I saw that I had some help today, even if I didn't come to collect the waste. And I think it's the guys on the beach, the migrant, who came to help me, so I will show you. So as you may know, if you come to Ventimiglia, the migrants actually sleep on the beach. And for this, they need some mattresses. And each day, since I started my waste station, actually on the beach, they come and they put their mattress beside the station. So, you know, during the day, it's better than on the beach. So proud of them, and because they try to do their part as well. And that's important. So as you can see, we have many colors, some red, some orange, some pink, and it's quite cloudy on the mountain, but it's just so beautiful and peaceful as well. So yes, that's our sunset for tonight, and tomorrow will be another day.